Like, comment, share, and subscribe. Pause the video right now to check out my social media, my radio show, and thatdrummerguy.com. And most of all, enjoy the following presentation.
Hello.
Hi, how's it going?
We're good. Yeah, we're good.
How are you?
I'm doing good. Thank you very much for taking the time to do this interview.
Thank you for doing it.
Yeah, thank you for having us.
Well, awesome. Well, I really appreciate you guys taking the time to be able to do this. Having discovered you guys from the previous album, it's awesome to be able to talk about the brand new album, Blood, which is coming out October 20th through Nuclear Blast.
That's correct, yes.
So what went into the songwriting for the new album?
Sorry, can you repeat?
So how did the songwriting come to be for the new album?
I didn't really have a plan, you know. I just started. This is Alex, by the way. I'm the one writing the songs for the band.
Yes.
I didn't really have a plan. What direction? Just you know, I just start writing and things happen, and then the band give their, how to say, inputs and inspiration into the music. So it just became the album as it is, you know. I don't know if that was a good answer.
Well, that's quite all right. I mean, I'm always curious about when it comes to that. Coming off from a previous album and what direction it's going to be going in next. I mean, it's always different for every band, so I'm always curious when it comes to that.
We decided quite early to invite another producer because I did the recordings on the three previous albums, and if I would have done the fourth album, it would have sounded exactly the same as the third, I think. So it's better. We all wanted to, you know, take a step further, and this time we had some budget, of course, and so why not invite a new guy into the team? And we found a friend of ours, Tom van Hesch. He's been working with lots of metal bands before, so maybe he has a kind of a big part in the construction around the album and the sound and arrangements.
Yeah, I noticed that as well. It's like when I've only had the album for around 24 hours or so, so I've only been able to check it out a couple times. But when it came to the production, I did notice a more heavier feel this time around. I mean, and knowing that it did come from somewhat of a background in metal form when it came to the production side, it makes a lot more sense now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So with that, I mean, with the songwriting and everything that came with that, how did you approach what you contributed to the band this time around?
You want to answer this one?
Sorry, I didn't really understand the question.
Oh, I mean, like, when everything was coming together to start writing the album, what did you have in mind as far as what direction you wanted the songs to go in?
I don't know. It was just we just play what Alex writes, but I think maybe you wanted to write. I don't know. I'm answering for you.
Yeah.
But, maybe you wanted to write something a little bit more accessible. A little less. I don't know.
Less gritty and less noisy, I think, this time, and a little bit accessible. I think Seth is on the right. He's got a point there. Because we, I think we're. I don't know if you have heard the first album and the second album.
Yes.
They are a bit more experimental and more. I'd say that it's noisier and more grit in the sound. And every album is heading for more classic songwriting, I suppose. You know, chorus and verse and bridges and I'm heading for a more classic kind of style of songwriting. I suppose.
And was it more of a challenge to be able to write in that style, or did it feel natural, or how did that come about?
It felt natural. It did.
Well, that's good to hear, too, because the songs do sound very natural on the album. I mean, everyone that's playing on the album, from the production, the songwriting, the lyrics, I mean, it feels like a very organic record.
Well, that's cool. That's good to hear.
Yeah, it's really good to hear, because we made it, we recorded it live in the studio, and the whole process was very organic, and it was a really nice studio. We lived there for a week, and even slept in they had places where you could stay, so we played everything live, so it's the whole process was very organic, so it's nice if it comes through when you hear it.
So with having that experience of being able to live at the studio and be able to record that way, did it feel better to be able to be in that kind of environment, to be able to fully live in the studio while recording?
Yeah, it was great. You sort of go into this bubble and just live and breathe the music, and everyone's very nice. It was really, that studio is, it's owned by the bass player of, do you know Soundtrack of Our Lives?
Yes.
Yeah, it's his studio in Gothenburg, and it's a really nice place. It's like a museum with vintage instruments and amplifiers and all kind of keyboards, so it's a really nice atmosphere to be in, very inspiring.
And with that, did that help with your approach when it came to like the songwriting of choosing what instruments to play or amplification or anything like that?
We had rehearsed quite a lot before, and so we knew quite exactly what we were going to do in the studio. And then, of course, there is always some space left, you know, for some spicing, you know,
some overdubs.
Yeah, some overdubs, and then you have you can try an old synth, or you can try another guitar if you like, and so it's mostly the same equipment we always use, the same gear.
Oh, very cool. So, of course, with the album coming out so very soon through Nuclear Blast, and some material has been released so far in single form, what has the reception been so far?
It's been good. It's been very positive so far.
Oh, that's good to hear. I mean, when you mentioned that the album is a bit more accessible, I think that was a very good approach to go about things, because, I mean, it really feels like the songs really cater to more accessibility, and it will make people want to go back and check out the previous albums as well to see where it came to this point.
Yeah, I suppose. You know, maybe in the future we will go back and try the first album again, you know, go back to the old sound, but that's nothing we're thinking of right now, because right now it's this album, Blood, that's the main focus on.
Oh, absolutely, of course. I just mean fans that may be just discovering you for the first time, knowing that with this being the fourth album, that they'll want to go back and check out the previous three albums.
Yeah, you can just hope that they like that too. I think the last album, Nyctophilion, was had a lot of I wouldn't say catchy, but had a lot of songs that could really, even if the sound is quite gritty and not very mainstream adult contemporary style, but it had a lot of songs that were quite catchy in their way.
Oh, very much so, and that's what really drew me into the band with the last album was. That kind of mix of the right amount of catchiness, I mean, all the different styles that was going along with it, and now seeing how you guys have progressed into what became now known as Blood, I mean, I really like the transition that's going on.
Thanks. Thanks.
Oh, no problem. So, what's next for the band?
We have a tour in November, but that's mostly in Germany and some other countries around. And then early 2018, we're going out for the next tour.
We're doing north of Europe in November, and then south of Europe in January.
Yeah, February. Mm. And then hopefully some festivals, but you know, they're working on right now, so we will see what will happen.
Oh, very cool. Now, so with that in mind, with the touring already being scheduled and upcoming shows are coming up very soon, how are you guys going about picking out a set list?
Yeah, that's going to be hard, of course, because everyone's got their ideas how to, you know, do a good concert. But I think it's we're going to come up with a nice playlist in the end.
We will play a lot from Blood.
Yeah.
It'll be we'll probably play most of the record, minus maybe two or three songs, and then some of the old songs.
Oh, that's really great to hear. I mean, with how much I've really been enjoying Blood. I mean, it's great to see that it will be getting some great representation live, because there are so many songs in there that feel like it would just be so natural to be able to play live.
Yeah, definitely. And that maybe is a result of them being recorded that way also. I'm really happy to play the new songs when we rehearse. And it's really, yeah, we should play all of them.
And with that in mind, I mean, if you do decide to play all the songs off the new album, I mean, would it be something that you would do from like start to finish? Or would it be changing up the order of anything? Or have you thought about that yet?
We'll do that. In 30 years, when we do the anniversary tour.
Oh, okay. Well, and also in speaking of that, I mean, of course, with the three previous albums now, I mean, it must feel really nice. I mean, even though the last three albums have been great, I mean, it's great to be able to have like a new album and really being able to spice up the set list just to have that kind of change going on.
Oh, yes, it is.
It is. We've been touring Nyctophilion and the other records for quite a long time now, so it's really nice to have some new songs also.
And with that being the case, you know, with the transition that's going on within the band for Blood, have you guys thought about how that's going to be affecting the direction of the musicality going forward?
Well, I haven't really thought about it that much.
You mean what will the next album sound like?
Yeah.
I have already started writing, actually, for new songs, but it's still, you know, in the cradle. It's very... it's hard to say it will take, but we'll see. Probably in a couple of months there will be some, you know, some ideas around the next album.
Oh, very cool. So getting back into Blood, how hard was it to be able to decide what songs you're going to be showing off before the album comes out?
What do you mean? You mean singles?
As far as
or?
Like the singles, yes.
That's, we decided to let Yuko Blast decide totally about the singles and which order and all that, so...
They did all that work,
yeah,
and we just said, okay.
Do you like what they've chosen as far as the singles go?
Yeah, I think it's a good choice.
We were a bit surprised. I won't say why, but there were some surprises, but we've gone along with that. We have a lot of respect for what they know, and they're a big label, and they're very successful, so they know what they're doing.
Yeah, this is the first time for us, you know, working with a big team, with a great staff like Nuclear Blast has, and so it's very obvious that they know what they're doing. So we feel quite confident, you know, working with them, and we feel their support. So it's good.
It's a very cool thing to see. I mean, when someone as huge as Nuclear Blast enjoys what you do so much that they want to be able to sign you, I mean, after all this time, I mean, and of course, with the diversity that's a part of the label, I mean, it's really great to see a more representation of a style like you guys being able to be shown off in such a great light.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're very happy about that also. It's an honor.
Yeah, and it's been some things are moving here in Europe, especially north of Europe. There are some how to say some post-punk movements, but it's not a big one. But you can sense that it's better than 5 years ago or 10 years ago. New bands are popping up, and there are some interesting bands from Italy and from Denmark, from Sweden, from Germany. from Belgium. So things are happening. So maybe there's something going on. I don't know.
Well, I mean, with that, I mean, I've always noticed that it does kind of go in cycles where sometimes it really comes to the forefront and sometimes it does go back a little bit. But, you know, it's getting back into it. I mean, I'm glad to see that Nuclear Blast took a chance with you guys with this new album. I mean, it's such a great representation of where you guys are right now, and having their backing and being able to show that off in a proper light. I mean, I just really hope that does pay off for you guys. And, you know, it's just like it does help you to be able to continue on creatively the direction you guys want to go in, because it's absolutely deserved.
Oh, thank you. And they haven't, to their credit, they haven't been controlling in any way of what we wanted to do. They've just they picked out the singles, and they haven't been controlling anything.
No, they give us free hands to do the trailers on YouTube and the videos. That's mostly us, you know, that decide who's going to do the video. And
yeah, also musically, we have the creative freedom.
Yeah,
and that's what I've always heard from Nuclear Blast, is that they really do respect the artists enough to be able to let them have their own creative freedom, because they believe in them enough, otherwise they wouldn't have signed them.
Mm-hmm. And that's really good. I think that's a very healthy way of working, I think.
Yeah, and again, I gotta say, it's really paid off for you guys. I mean, I know you already had the album in mind and everything, but, you know, just like seeing the promotion, you know, it's like this is the most promotion that I've seen for you guys since I've discovered you guys on my own, and the fact that I've seen so much great reception through social media, through different music outlets, like really digging what they hear from the new album and from you guys. I mean, it's really great to see, and it's great to see this representation.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's good. It's, you know, we couldn't be happier.
For someone like me that hasn't really gotten the chance to be able to experience you guys live yet, and with these upcoming shows that are going to be happening through this album cycle, what should people expect from a live show from you guys?
Rock and roll. It's rock, you know, but with a under the post-punk flag.
It's loud, and it's a lot of white light and smoke,
and no synthesizers on stage.
No, and real drums. A lot of bands on the scene don't have real drums, and that's we always get credit for that. Mm. And I think it's such a it's very we think it's really
obvious.
I don't know. I can't find the word. It's something you have to have, real drums.
Yeah, I think so. It's a natural rock element that I don't mind drum machines, but I haven't really seen that much great shows with bands playing drum machines. It's a total different experience watching a drummer play or listening to a drummer.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. I mean, as a drummer myself, it's like I always appreciate when there are real drums on stage. I mean, I can understand if there's like some sample drums to go along with real drums, or on an album, like sometimes sample drums do work out better in the circumstances rather than real drums. But as far as like a live show, nothing beats that real feeling of real musicians being able to play.
Exactly. So we don't have any backtracks or anything, except for the walk-in intro or something. But we don't use any backtracks in the songs and when we're playing live. So I think they can expect a good rock show watching us play. That's what we were aiming for.
So with that in mind, I mean, with not having backing tracks except for like the walk-in intro, do you use any click tracks on stage, or is it all just like going off the drummer, or how does that go?
No click tracks. It's only we follow Jonas, the drummer.
Oh, that's really cool to hear. I mean, that really shows how tight you guys can be then, because I know a lot of bands in this style, like, they either do use the sample drums, or they use the click track, or using everything from a laptop. So the fact that you guys really are going that extra mile and making sure that everything does have that real feel to it, that's really cool to see.
Yeah, we also, most of us, or all of us, we come from a punk background also, so it's very natural for us to just do it that way.
Yeah,
it's not too much technology, just
great gear and just play.
Oh, that's so cool to hear. Well, guys, thank you so very much for taking this time to be able to talk to me about everything going on in the world of Then Comes Silence. And, of course, talking about the brand new album, Blood, which is coming out in just a couple weeks through Nuclear Blast. Like I said, I've been able to check out the album. I've only gotten a few spins of it so far, but I really love what I'm hearing for it so far. I mean, from, like, start to finish, I mean, it doesn't feel like there's any mediocre or songs that were forced to be put on there. I mean, everything just feels very real, natural and organic, and that's what I really appreciate in this style, is when the songs are written that way. And I really think that you guys have written some of the best material the band has done to date.
Oh, thank you. It's great to hear.
Before we wrap things up, is there anything else you'd like to mention that I hadn't brought up yet?
It's hard to say. No, I don't know. I was going to, you know, talk about, you know, the importance of using drums, but we already mentioned it. So, that one is already we already
covered that.
Yeah, exactly.
No, I don't know. I think we covered most of what we wanted to say.